of goodies from the refrigerator at night. It was such a magnificent invention back then. Our Sultan paid the price of 2 cars for each one. Now look at them, as good as having 2 clocks on a wall.
This must be the kitchen. So, this is where you work?
Yes, every day at 7 a.m.
It's not like it used to be. I can see that.
It was very lively once upon a time. A proper kitchen with the smell of garlic and dal and a jolly cook. He and I were such good friends. He used to call me his little papadum and bake me special treats every week. It was our little secret. Whenever the Sultan brought back guests, there would be grand banquets and plenty of food for the servants. He was very generous in that fashion.
Wow, it almost looks like there's a fire here.
Electricity at the turn of the century. Yes, it was the pride and joy of Singapore. How ironic that an electrical fire would turn it all to smoke.
Why doesn't anyone live in the mansion anymore?
The Sultan didn't think it was a good investment to rebuild. And so he never did.
I see. What did you do? Where do you go after that?
Many places, all gone now. I settled down close to here some years later, but I had to leave that home as well. I couldn't bear the sights and sounds of the past that haunted me. Acrid fumes from the huts mingled with the smell of charred bodies. It was a hospital, you know. Those heartless murderers bombed the hospital. 700 Indian soldiers, all wounded, lit up like so much kindling under a Red Cross target. Please, let's leave. The stench is cloying. No wind will ever wash it away.
Are you all right?
Yes, I'll be all right. It's very overwhelming looking into the past, but it's also necessary.
Wait. Where are we going?
There's more for you to see. Come.
Oh, okay.
Clark Quay. It used to be so polluted. I remember the bumboats would jostle against each other like bees in a honeycomb, unloading cargo at their sovereign warehouse. It was loud here with the workers shouting and shrill whistles in the air. Pretty lights at night now, isn't that so?
Yes, you can even drink on one of those tongkangs. They've turned them into floating bars. I guess all the warehouses have become clubs now too.
Isn't that silly? Turning a tongkang into a pub. I suppose people will always be looking for a new experience.
I've been on one. It's not really a big experience. Just the good use of the tongkangs.
Did you know? The eyes on the bumboats are a Chinese tradition. It's a belief that the boats can then see the proper direction and won't get lost if they have eyes. They used to scare me when I was younger. I thought they were monsters. Well, they certainly smell like monsters. This is interesting. Coolies cast in bronze, forever locked in their labor. Their toil is an accessory to beautification. Funny how we decorate the cityscape with our past, yet nobody seems to care. I used to come here in the Colonel's entourage. Such dresses like if only seen in paintings, dancing all night around the crystal punch bowls. A real taste of Europe, you know. The piano player, Gerald Atkins was his name. Yes. That man could play all night long with a straight back and a smile. He died in the late 30s, caught a fever when he was traveling in Burma. The man who replaced him was a stuck-up fellow with stiff fingers, nothing like Gerald. Yes, I remember, every Saturday night.
Every Saturday? It must have been quite grand.
Yes, dear, very grand. But those things are temporary, aren't they? Grand things only last as long as the money does. I remember when this was made. Do me a favor, dear. Whenever you pass by the cenotaph, take a moment to think of those who lost their lives for your generation.
I will.
You go for walks here?
Not anymore, but I used to. I'd go for long leisurely strolls along the waterfront and look at the ships in the harbor. That's peculiar.
Do you remember this fountain?
I do, but something seems different. I don't quite remember the field behind it. I don't know, maybe it's just me. My memory fails even me now. But I thought it was down that way.
Where the fountain was?
Yes, that's where I remember it.
It was so much nearer to the Fullerton Hotel.
That's the General Post Office, dear.
The what?
Or at least, it used to be the General Post Office.
General Post Office? Oh. Things change.
Some buildings are the same everywhere you go. City Hall is that universal place. I remember when the Japanese rounded up the British and marched them all to Changi and Siloso. And about 20 years later, here we all were, at the Padang, watching our first National Day parade. Oh, the significance of this place.
It's going to be an art gallery soon. I don't think it's used for politics anymore. Auntie, I wanted to thank you for showing me where you grew up. This is where I did. Good old Gimmore.
I remember how my grandfather brought me down here every evening to teach me how to cycle. He'd hold my hand, patiently guiding me up and down this path till I got it right. Then one day, he removed the training wheels and let me go. I was so afraid of being away from him, but he told me I had to. I guess we all have to learn how to let go. It's a good neighborhood, this one, with many good people. Most of my neighbors have lived here for almost 40 years. They've raised children who've since moved out, but they and the lives they've built remain. In 2 years, all this will be gone. The government is tearing it down to build another condo. Those make more money, I suppose. Pity, though.
Oh yes, and thank you so much for your time. Can I walk you home?
I'm afraid that's not possible, dear. My journey takes me far away from this place, from all that used to be mine.
What do you mean?
Farewell, young one. I leave my memories with you now. Never forget what has happened here today. It is your duty to speak for those without a voice.
The streets are paved with hands of a thousand different bodies, a timeless poetry etched with sweat and shovel, every footprint wearing away the concrete, until the poetry becomes dust. I cannot see the memories in the dust, because they are not mine, but the knowledge of their existence now shapes my world. Here I am, leaning against a tree at the crossroads of twilight, where carriages turn into cars and the whinnying of horses meld into the airy bring of Toyotas. The memories are there, listlessly roaming like leaves caught in a whirlwind under the street lamps that fade into the distance. But whether they fade into the past or future, I cannot tell.